In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Geometry free worksheet Similar Polygons. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Similar polygons are polygons where the corresponding angles are congruent and the corresponding sides are proportional. So let's look at number one, given that our directions are to state if the polygons are similar. In number one, we have two rectangles. All the corresponding angles are indeed congruent. Now we just have to check to see if the sides are proportional. So we're going to see if this side length of 10 over this side length of 14 is proportional to this side length, 15, the smaller length, to this larger length, 21. So we're going to see if 10 is to 14 as 15 is to 21. So 10 14ths, is that equal to 15 21sts? And how we'll see is by cross multiplying. So 10 will get multiplied to 21, so 10 times 21, and is that equal to 14 times 15? 10 times 21 is 210, and 14 times 15 is also 210. And number one, yes, these polygons, rectangles in this case, are similar, since 210 equals 210. In number two, again, we're given two rectangles, so we know that the angles are indeed congruent. So we're going to look to see if this shorter side in this first rectangle, 24, over the long side, 36, is the same proportion as 18, the short side of the second rectangle, over the long side of the bottom rectangle. So in this, we're going to cross multiply. 24 times 24, does that equal 36 times 18? 24 times 24 is 576. 36 times 18 is 648. So 576 does not equal 648, therefore these two rectangles are not similar. In number three, we're looking at two parallelograms. So first, let's check for corresponding angles and see if they're congruent. We're given that this angle is 40 degrees, so we need to see if this short angle over here is 40 degrees. Well, if this angle is 130, and we know that those are corresponding interior angles, so they add up to 180. So 180 degrees minus 130 degrees equals 50 degrees. So this angle is 50 degrees. And in a parallelogram, this will be 130, and this will also be 50 degrees. However, if this angle is 40 degrees, there's no angle within this second parallelogram that is 40 degrees. Therefore, the corresponding angles are not congruent, and these two parallelograms are not similar. In number four, let's check the angles. This angle is 100 degrees, and that's congruent to this angle of 100 degrees. And in a parallelogram, we know that opposite angles are congruent. So this is 100 degrees, meaning that this angle is 100 degrees, and those are also congruent. And since these are consecutive interior angles, this 100 degrees and this angle here, they will add up to 180 degrees. So 180 degrees minus that angle that we know of 100 degrees equals 80 degrees. And same for this second parallelogram. This is also 80 degrees. And opposite angles are congruent. So 80 degrees, and then opposite the 80 degrees in the second parallelogram, 80 degrees. So we have first that all corresponding angles are congruent. Now we need to see if the corresponding sides are proportional. Let's see if this short side, 24, over the long side, 48, is proportional to this short side of 20 over the long side of 40. Cross multiplying, 24 times 40, does that equal 20 times 48? 24 times 40 is 960, and 20 times 48 is also 960. So in number 4, we have two similar parallelograms, and that's because corresponding angles are congruent and corresponding sides are proportional. Number 5, we have two trapezoids, and we need to see if the corresponding sides are proportional since the corresponding angles are indeed congruent. So the shorter base 8 to the side 9.1, is that proportional to the shorter base 10 to the side 16.7? Cross multiplying, we'll do 8 times 16.7, and is that equal to 9.1 times 10? 8 times 16.7 is 133.6, and 9.1 times 10 is 91. 91 does not equal 133.6, therefore the trapezoids in number 5 are not similar. In number 6, the corresponding angles are indeed congruent. So let's see if 25 over 15.5 is proportional to the smaller base 20 over 12.4. So 20 over 12.4, is that proportional to the smaller base in the second one, 25 over the side 15.5? Cross multiplying, 20 times 15.5, does that equal 12.4 times 25? 20 times 15.5 is 310, and 12.4 times 25 is also 310. So yes, those are proportional. But now we need to check the other base. So we're going to do the larger base, 28, to the side 12.4. And is that proportional to the larger base 35 to 15.5? Cross multiplying, 28 times 15.5, does that equal 12.4 times 35? 28 times 15.5 is 434, and 12.4 times 35 is also 434. So yes, those are also proportional. Therefore, in number 6, the trapezoids are indeed similar. In number 7, we can see that corresponding angles are indeed congruent, because those two angles would be 80 degrees. Therefore, the remaining two angles will have to be 100 degrees in this first parallelogram. And opposite angles are congruent, so this is 100 degrees, and 180 minus 100 is 80. So this is also 80 degrees. So we have opposite angles of 80 degrees and 100 degrees in the first one, and then opposite angles of 80 degrees and 100 degrees in the second one. So corresponding angles are indeed congruent. Now let's check for corresponding sides. We're going to look at the shorter side 5 over the longer side 6. And is that proportional to the shorter side 16 over the longer side 24? When we cross multiply, we'll do 5 times 24 and see if that's equal to 6 times 16. 5 times 24 is 120. And 6 times 16 is 96. Since 120 does not equal 96, the corresponding sides are not proportional. Therefore, in number 7, these parallelograms are not similar. In number 8, 180 degrees minus 70 degrees equals 110 degrees. So this angle is 110. Opposite angles are congruent, so this angle is 110 and this angle is 70 degrees. And since we've already calculated what the consecutive interior angle length is, this is also 110, since 110 plus 70 is 180, and opposite angles are congruent in a parallelogram. Indeed, we have that corresponding angles are congruent. So now let's look at the sides. We'll start with the shorter side 7 over the longer side 8. And we're going to see if to the shorter side 32 over the longer side of 36. When we cross multiply, 7 will get multiplied to 36, and 8 will get multiplied to 32. 7 times 36 is 252, and 8 times 32 is 256. So since 252 does not equal 256, the parallelograms in number 8 are not similar. In number 9, they show us that corresponding angles are congruent. So let's check the sides. We'll do the longer base 40 over the side 17.3. And is that proportional to 24, the longer base, over the side 9.4? Cross multiplying, 40 times 9.4, is that equal to 17.3 times 24? 40 times 9.4 is 376. 17.3 times 24 is 415.2. 376 does not equal 415 2/10. Therefore, in number 9, the polygons are not similar. And lastly in this video, I'll go over number 10. In number 10, we're given two rectangles, and 90 degrees is congruent to 90 degrees. Therefore, all the corresponding angles are congruent. So now we just have to see if the corresponding sides are proportional. We're going to check the smaller side of the rectangle over the larger side of the first rectangle, so that's 30 over 35. And is that proportional to the smaller side of the second rectangle, 18 over the larger side, 21? 30 times 21, does that equal 35 times 18? The cross multiplication. 30 times 21 equals 630. And 35 times 18 also equals 630. So since the sides are proportional in number 10, the rectangles are similar. And with that answer, we'll wrap up this video. Join me in the next video where I'll finish out this worksheet completing numbers 11 through 18. And if you have any questions, leave a comment below. And like always, subscribe and like this video. If you've already subscribed and liked, feel free to share this video as well.